zingers, which are actually my favorite lure, are amazing because they spin on the line, but when Ling Cods grab a hold, they can, their sharp teeth can cut through the line right there. So Spinnow, they got a metal rod running through. They don't cut through it. Green hollow. Let's go perch, 150 gram.
I want to pick my lure.
Okay. Oh, Jane is going with pink holographic Buzzbomb. That's actually the perfect size for your rod. Should be able to get down 30 feet off the cliff where we're going. The worst hazard to marine navigation on the British Columbia coast. Crazy, hey, Jana? So many ships went under and died. The view used to be much better, but all these alder trees filled in. They grow like weeds. This is some of the best Ling Cod habitat in the world. They're an ambush predator, so they sit on the rock and the food comes by, they just grab it. So we are going to a secret spot called Cougar Cliff, where we're fishing right off the cliff up there in the Seymour and Arrows. You're not as light as you were last time we came here. Jada's got the first fish.
Look at this guy.
Oh, nice!
He's definitely not.
Here, bring over here to the camera. First fish of the day. Here, I might as well get him off for you.
See, I told you I was gonna catch the first fish. Let's name him Spike.
Okay, see you later, Spike.
He's not big enough for us. Bye, Spike!
Oh, belly flop. There he goes.
Look at, he's swimming down! He's going back in the rocks over there, cool!
Jana, I'm into something.
Oh my god.
Look at that guy. Grab me the pliers. I don't trust this guy. Okay, so I'm just going to let him off here for a second.
And then. That's like the biggest rock cut I've
seen. See ya, buddy.
What? We're not eating him?
No, we'll let him go. Well, I just lost my first lure.
Yay, Yorta, you licked the fish!
Yeah.
Wasn't me!
We have a rule. Whoever loses the first lure has to lick the fish.
Hey, Dad, you gotta lick him.
Oh, yeah, that's right. Oh!
You gotta lick that guy. Can't wait to see the look in your face.
Ah, salty!
You licked the fish!
Oh! The eagle just came and took a fish. All right, so here's how I like to do things. Braid. I've got 40 pound braid here. I'm just gonna take a section of it off.
Braid is line, right?
Yeah, braided line.
Cool.
So I go braid, and I do a type of a nail knot to connect it to fluorocarbon leader. And usually I go anywhere from 3 to 6 feet of fluorocarbon, and then I go to the lure from the fluoro. So what I do is I create a loop on the braid and a loop on the fluoro, and I go through the loop and wrap it five this way and then five back over and make sure I go back through the loop the same way that I came in. And then I pull it all tight, and it creates what I'm a fly fishing background, so I call that, it's kind of like a nail knot, the way that it connects everything.
And that's what my braid to fluorocarbon connection looks like. I just prefer fluoro over mono. I feel like it's stronger, personally. More abrasion resistant, which is good for rock fishing. And I'll pull out about, I don't know, whatever. It's rock cod and ling cod, they're pretty forgiving. They're not like trout where they're super picky, so I'll just pull 3 or 4 feet out. And then I've got all my barbs clipped off.
I got all my barbs clipped off.
And then I'll do, this is called a modified clinch knot. I go through once. And in commercial fishing, when you're tying gear, you go through a second time. And I really like that because then there's 2 points of line that resist abrasion on the eyelet of the lure. So I go through twice. With thick line like this, I'll wrap like 3 or 4 times. 1, 2, 3. And then I go through the 2 loops that I created. And then back over the top loop.
Beef jerky's still on.
Nice. And then with fluorocarbon, apparently you're not supposed to wet it. With mono, I always lick that thing like crazy. So I get it somewhat tight, and then I'll just cinch that thing as tight as I can. I pull as hard as I can. With 40-pound test fluorocarbon, you can crank that thing so hard. And when you clip it, you want to leave a few millimeters, because if you hook the bottom, sometimes it tightens just a little bit more, enough to pull the tag end through and under your knot. So I leave about that much. That's my setup. For what I'm doing right now. Oh, this spot is seriously epic looking. I've never come this far along here before. Oh, yep. Okay, please watch your step coming along here. Right? Stay along the flat section, and we're coming up here. There we go. Yeah. Well, it happened so quick, honey. You knew about it before I did. I gotta get him in before he runs into the rocks. He hit hard, it's probably a little ling cod. The way he hit was definitely the attack of a ling cod. It's just a little guy though. Yeah, exactly what I thought. Look at that, it's a little ling cod. Man, ling cod just have a very distinct way of hitting. It's like he just jumped out and snatched. Oh my goodness, there's another fish in his throat. Oh, I gotta get this. Check this out. This guy, no, he's way too small. We gotta let him go. Look at this, there's a fish. Look at that herring that this guy was eating. See ya, bud. That was not a very friendly release, but that's the way it goes sometimes. No, that's not what I want. That's really not what I want. She's on there, good. Well, I have to lick another fish. So, lost my lure. Kept the connection from the braid to the fluorocarbon. And it was a snap. So all the knots held really well. We'll come back another day. More lures. All right, so me and Jana had an awesome day together. Hey, sweetie?
Yeah.
Was that so fun?
Yeah.
But I didn't get what I came for, which is a monster ling cod off the cliff. So I'm gonna make a part two of this video. And I'm gonna come back here in a day or two. Solo, so I can go into the more kind of treacherous spots along the cliff and maybe cover some more ground. I'm gonna come back with a backpack full of lures because I'm gonna lose 10 if I spend a whole day here, and I'm gonna hook into something big, and I'm gonna get it on film. See you in part two. Okay, Here we go. This is it.
Check out that water. You do not want to fall in that. That's super cold, and it's probably 100 feet deep here. No forgiveness.
We got kelp greenling. We call them Tommy Cod. What are you doing? Here's another little Ling Cod. There we go. There's a monster. Okay, we got a monster Ling Cod. It's a monster. This is what we've been waiting for, folks. Oh. He's a big one. Bigger than 10 for sure. It's hard to tell with all this current though. I'm up on the cliff. There's no way to get this guy in. So hopefully we just get a glimpse of him. Head shakes. You know what? The current has definitely made this guy feel bigger than he is. I can see him now. He's not pinner. Jeez, this could get dangerous here. All right, buddy. Show us the goods. Come on, boy. Oh, yeah. All right, buddy. See you later. Woo! Wash that yucky slime off. All right, I don't know how I'm getting down, but I'm gonna commit. Yes. New spot. Apparently not that new, as there's a rope to get down. Teeth. I got some cuts from that one.